gonna build a mountain from a little hill. Hey guys, and thank you so much for tuning into my channel. My name is The Lead Designer, and today we are back with another speed build video of our city zoo. And in this episode, we are obviously going to add one of the European animals of the Europack. But quickly, before we jump into it, let us thank our fantastic sponsor of the channel, Instant Gaming. At Instant Gaming, you can get your most favorite games with up to 70, sometimes even 90% discount. If you use the link in the description down below, you will get an amazing discount and you will also be supporting the channel. And to celebrate this awesome collaboration, we are doing a special giveaway where you can win a game of your choice. So just click the link in the description of this video, enter the game or DLC you would like to win and participate. Good luck! Now for those of you that have seen like this planning map I've made a while back, I think it was right after the North America Animal Pack, I made like this screenshot of like an overview of City Zoo, and I basically tried to plan out like the habitats where I want all the animals to be that we don't have yet in the zoo. Well, not all the animals, but we are getting very close to having all the animals in City Zoo, but I'm not really sure if we are able to really add all the animals because, well, we are getting so many new animals all the time with these DLCs as well. So yeah, I'm not really sure if we are able to add every single animal of Planet Zoo in City Zoo, but who knows, we shall see, only time will tell. But yeah, for those of you that remember, there was like this spot on the bottom right where basically it's still empty, but we could basically add some animals there, and it actually feels like a perfect spot for the European animals. Like, it's not a super big spot, so I feel like it's just a perfect match for these four animals of the European pack to finish that little corner off. Like, it really was the only area that you were like, yeah, well, maybe someday in the future we will get a nice DLC and we could add some animals in there. And I think the European pack is just perfect for that. And also, for a little bit more reference, this habitat is located right next to the red kangaroo habitat. So basically, right next to the Australian area that we already finished now. And it's also pretty close to the warthog and aardvark habitat, but those two are on the other side of the water. But just to give you a little bit of an idea, I also added a little bit of an overview shot at the cinematic shots to give you a little bit more of an idea, not of the whole zoo, but to the region where this habitat is being added in our city zoo. Now, we actually wanted to start with a lynx habitat, but having such a little space and I didn't really like the idea of having the lynx first for this European area, I started with the European badger instead. I obviously want to try and use a little bit more of the new pieces of the pack as well for this habitat. And this stone wall is actually just perfect for a habitat fence. I really love it that we finally got some 2 meter wide non-grid pieces for most building sites now, because this is making life so much easier, and it's just a lot more easier for me personally to work with a 2 meter wide fence instead of, like, mostly we work with the 4 meter wide walls for fences unless we use the 2 meter wide fences that we already had in the game. But now have, oh man, these stone pieces, this new stone building set is just perfect for the edge that I had in my mind for this particular habitat. So I think it's just really, really perfect. So we dug out some terrain on the edges of the habitat, and after that I started building these fences with like these stone walls and some plaster pieces as well to be able to connect it all nicely with the path that we're making around the habitat. So the middle of the terrain of the habitat, it wants to have a little bit more higher, so more like a little bit higher on eye level, if that makes any sense. And we obviously are going to add the burrow for the badgers on that little hill that you saw me place down with the terrain tool. And then around the habitat and like the terrain that we dug out, there will be a lot of water. This will be more as a natural fence next to the stone walls.
So on the other side of the habitat, it wanted to create a little building. Even though the badgers now have the burrows to take shelter and sleep, etc., I still find it useful to have this little building with some... maybe it looks a little bit like a small little aviary. I'm not really sure if you can call it an aviary, but we have some chain link fences on one side so the guests can still look into the building. And I think it really also is useful for the staff to be able to like close the doors, maybe have a little check on all the badgers. And maybe they need to do something in the badger habitat, so it's important for the staff to make sure that the badgers are not running around everywhere for safety or whatsoever. So yeah, having this little building still makes a lot more sense to me. And it could also be potentially some kind of old building, like back in the days, this really was just a very small city zoo habitat with just some really plain things inside it, like we only have a little rock in there. And a few branches, very simple, very plain. Also, of course, do not hurt the traversable area of the badgers. But maybe some kind of idea like that, and later they added like this whole natural area for the badgers as well. So they can now enjoy a lot more space. So maybe that could also be a little bit of history idea behind this building still. But yeah, I do still think that for staff it might be useful to be able to lure them inside, close the doors maybe, and because they have to do a check or whatever they have to do in the habitat. I think it does make sense to still have this kind of building next to a burrow. So obviously with this building, we also have a perfect spot to play around with these new decals of the pack. And oh boy, do they look amazing. And oh boy, did they improve your buildings of how they look so much. It looks so much more realistic. I absolutely love it. Actually, really, really love them more than I thought when I saw them the first time with doing like the overview video of the pack. I really did like them. But now that I'm using them, I absolutely love them. They really make your zoo look so much better. Now, this honestly does mean I need to go through City Zoo now and just add these decals everywhere just to make the whole zoo look so much better and more realistic. Is this something you guys would find interesting to see as well? Like, I was actually thinking to maybe just do a video with, like, not recording putting down all the decals. I mean, that is just super boring. But just have, like, okay, one shot before, one shot after. And we just go through the whole zoo, through all the buildings at least, and just show you guys, like, okay, this was before we had the decals, and now, boom, this is a shot when after we got the decals. Something like that. Like, I don't want to, like, overkill it like too much throughout the zoo. Like, obviously I love to play around with that right now because it just looks super amazing, but obviously like doing each and every building as much as this building doesn't really make sense to me. So it should be a little bit toned down, I feel like, sometimes a little bit more, sometimes a little bit less, something like that. I don't know, just play around with the decals and just show you guys an before and an after shot of how things are looking. Is that something you guys would like to see? Like, I'm not going to promise that I will be doing that because it's going to take a lot more work to make a video like that instead of me just going through the whole zoo and just putting down decals. Just let me know in the comments down below if this is something you would find interesting to see. Now, inside of this little building, I did add like a rock and a few of the new habitat branches. Nothing really spectacular. Like, this still is a city zoo with more older habitats, and I find this sort of style that we are going for just really enough, basically. And it would also hurt the traversable area on the inside, so we should not put down too many things in there. And the rest of the building is pretty much the same style as the other City Zoo buildings that we have so far. Only this one has a wooden roof instead of like the pink clay tile roofs. Like, I find this a little bit more fitting for the European area, since this is all probably going to be a little bit more dense, a little bit more foresty. I'm probably going to use a little bit more stone and more wood throughout this whole area. I think that just fits a little bit better for the European, and we could like make this just stand out a little bit more as a different area for Europe. So I do think that it all matches the idea at least. but still staying with the same style of City Zoo, of course. And then it was obviously time to place down the burrow. Like, I really do hope one day we will see different sizes of the burrows. Like, I actually think this burrow entrance is still a little bit too big, maybe, for the badgers and the aardvarks. It would be really nice to see something a little bit more narrow. And in general, just like maybe different size of burrows for like bears and meerkats, for example. That would be just super cool to see. Did Frontier actually say something about this? Like, if they are going to expand burrowing in the future for other animals? I actually have no idea. Like, maybe they mentioned something on the forums that I missed out on. That would be just super amazing, honestly. So do let me know if you have read something about that that I totally missed out on. Okay, but back to the burrow that we are placing right now. Like, I really wanted to hide away a little bit with some rocks and, like, this big log, obviously. And I think this really does look nice. And I also added, like, a bit of the African grass around it and some small faux rocks with a little bit of moss and stuff. So, yeah, hiding it away, making it a little bit more natural. I think it really works out. I'm actually really happy that we have something a little bit different. For chains, like the burrows, it's not super spectacular, but it's definitely something new that we can work with. And I can only hope that in the future, Frontier is going to expand this idea a little bit for other animals as well. And with different sizes, that will be just really amazing. Now, I obviously also really wanted to use a few of the new trees. Like, we are building a European zoo, so we are able to really use these new European trees because they just fit super perfectly in this zoo. And obviously the new oak trees are a perfect fit in our city zoo together with the normal oak trees that we were using a lot already. So I am definitely going to use these. I think they're called cork. The word is so funny. Cork oak trees or something like that. Correct me if I'm wrong, I think I'm definitely going to use these trees a lot more throughout the whole zoo. I think that's gonna look really nice, but obviously this one being the kickoff of using some other oak trees instead of the big humongous oak trees only. Like, we obviously are using them as well in this habitat because I really want to have this foresty vibe that we have going on a little bit throughout the zoo. I also really want to have that in this habitat. I don't want it to be plain. I want it to be more dense looking. So yeah, definitely also using the beautiful oak trees that I absolutely love to work with in the zoo. And the rest of the habitat is obviously pretty much just decorating it with a lot of rocks, faux rocks, some logs and trees and bushes. Also using a few of the new trees, the new trees are already set, but also the new bushes that we have. I'm not really sure what it was, something with the dog name, something with dog in it, but I can't remember. Dog rose bush, I think I see in the speed build of my video, like very small, so I'm not really sure if I'm reading that right. But yes, also the new bushes of the new pack, or was it a free update? I actually started out myself. I think those are from the free update. Are those oak trees from the free update as well? No, I think the oak trees are from the European pack, if I remember correctly. I start to doubt myself again because it could also be the olive trees that I'm confused with. Anyways, doesn't really matter. I really do hope that you guys like the end result of the badger habitat, of course. Around the whole habitat, it's still obviously very plain and empty, but we're obviously going to fill this soon up with the trees and bushes that we did all around the whole zoo. So I'm probably going to do that off camera very soon. And for the lings, we're probably going to build some kind of more of like a closed off aviary or something like that. I saw some really cool pictures of that on Google, so I think I'm going to use that as inspiration for the European lynx habitat that we're going to build soon. I wish I would just wait and see how that is going to turn out, obviously. Now, please do let me know in the comments down below, of course, what you guys think of this European badger habitat. Also, let me know what you guys think so far of the Europack. Now you had time to play around with it a little bit. And what you think of the stuff and all the animals. Leave a like in the video if you guys enjoyed this video. And subscribe, of course, if you haven't already. And also do not forget to check out the giveaway we are doing with Instant Gaming with the link in the description down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. And I really do hope to see you guys all in the next one. Bye, guys!